Nice to meet here from Sassy Mustang 1980. So today I'm going to just do a review update on a couple of things. The first one I'm going to review update on is the fly repellent that I got a couple of weeks ago. As you guys remember, this is the one that has the DEET in it. So I did end up using the shampoo and both the fly spray over the last couple of weeks because the flies were so bad. Now, I will say that the fly spray and both the shampoo work really, really good, far more than I had expected. I did a control test with the shampoo. I washed both Dixie and Sassy with the shampoo here. A little goes a lot. I mean, a little goes a really long way. What I ended up using was one of those little face curry combs that has the little nods in it. And I put the shampoo in there, probably about a quarter size, and I kind of moved it around the horse, and it covered the whole horse with really good lather. I left it on the horse for about 2 minutes just so it could soak in. Then I rinsed it off, like it said on the thing. I used a sweat scraper to scrape the majority of the water off, and then I let the horse air dry. Did not let the horses roll, just because I didn't want it to kind of deteriorate the fly repellent stuff. Now, the shampoo alone worked really good. I didn't see any flies on the horses for about a week after I used the shampoo. I left Fancy without being washed just to see kind of a control of how bad the flies really were. Poor Fancy got, you know, bit by mosquitoes and gnats and all the other little biting bugs out there. So that's pretty good. That means that the fly shampoo works really, really well. Like I said, I saw a huge improvement. There weren't any deer flies or bombers or greenheads or mosquitoes or any of those other annoying little things biting the horses at all. So it worked really well. I was very pleased. Then it rained. And of course, with the rain, it did wash off of the horse, which is normal. You know, any fly spray or stuff will wash off once it rains. Even the water resistant stuff, it doesn't stay on like it says. So once it rained, it washed all the stuff off, and of course the horses were bugged by flies again. I started using the spray bottle one, and that goes a long way too. It has a really fine spray mist, which is different than the ones you find here in the U.S., where it's just kind of like a round splotch area on the horse where you can see where most of it goes, and then a little bit isn't on there. This has kind of like a really nice fine mist that covers the horse evenly, so I would spray Sassy, because she's the bigger one right now. I sprayed one side 4 times, the neck, the shoulder, the belly, the flank, which covered her butt, and then her belly on both sides. And that kept her covered up pretty good. And of course, instant improvement, no biting flies anywhere. I didn't spray her legs just because I'm kind of one of those people who don't spray legs. So I did put it on my hands and I wiped it over her face and her ears and I wiped it down her legs. And then, again, no flies. Now, the other one, the fly spray says that it will last in good conditions up to 12 hours. I did notice it does last longer than that, depending on the weather. So if it's really, really hot and the horse is sweating, it lasts about 5 hours, 4 to 5 hours. If it's cooler outside, like it is today, where it's not overly humid and it's just kind of a nice sunny day with no humidity, it will definitely last longer than 12 hours. I think the longest it lasted me was almost 20 hours. And that was because the weather, like I said, the conditions in the weather have to be right. So as far as recommendation goes, I highly recommend getting this product if you live in a really fly-infested area. It works really, really well. It is a little pricey. I don't remember how much it was. I think it was like $20 for this. And then the other bottle was about $25. Don't quote me on that. It's in my other video. I got this from the UK. I had it shipped over. Shipping wasn't too bad. It was about $4 to $5, so it wasn't too bad. Highly recommend it. A little goes a long way. This bottle is still really full, and I washed 2 horses. Like I said, I used quarter-size beads and made sure it was lathered over the horses. So worth the money. Totally worth the money. So if you have any questions about the fly spray, go ahead and leave me a comment down below. I will try to answer it as quickly as possible. Haven't been too busy, you know, so that's good. And other than that, that's my review for the Lincoln fly spray or a fly repellent. It does contain DEET. Also, a quick note, make sure you don't have any cuts on your hands or get it in your eyes or anything because it burns like hell. I had a cut on my hand when I was washing Sassy and I felt it instantly. It does burn pretty bad. So it's pretty harsh to the skin. Anyways, thanks for watching. I will talk to you guys later. I will be making another review real quickly, so I'm not going to be changing my attire, probably fluff up my hair a little bit. So talk to you guys later. Happy trails. Keep your heels down and be safe out there.